Oh my God. Oh, I'm tripping. How I'm gonna put a helmet on and I put a whole ass bun in my head. Y'all wanna see a trick? Oh. Are we on the air?
Ready or not? Here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna
What's good, YouTube? We back with another banger, bro. So today we're gonna do the what's in my bag video. I don't know if that's what it's called or not, but that's what I'm gonna call it. Feel me? We gonna see what's in my football bag, see some of my football gear that I've been using for some for a long time, and then some for, you know, I just got. So I'll kind of go through some things, explain a little bit, and y'all kind of see some of my wardrobe and all that stuff. So we're gonna get straight into it. All right, so first things first, some of this stuff y'all might not be familiar with. I did play arena football for a while. Like, I've been playing arena football since I was like 19, 20 years old. I'm gonna show y'all anyway, kind of explain to y'all some of the stuff that I've been using throughout the years. So these right here are my alphas, man. This right here basically is grip for the turf. Because we don't play on grass or like actual like grass turf. We play on carpet. We call it like carpet turf. So these are a pair of my alphas right here. Very essential, man. They got the ankle support, you feel me? But yeah, so these are very essential right here. Then we got another pair of alphas. These right here are very special to me. I'll never let them go. So for those of you that don't really know me well, my mom passed away of colon cancer in 2015. One of my arena seasons, I decided to go like all blue. So I had got blue gloves, blue alphas with the ridges and everything. But due to the color scheming issue that we had with all the teams and stuff, we were not allowed to wear colors that were not our color for that season. That season, I played with the Wichita Forest. I played quarterback for the Wichita Forest. And they were fining us left and right. Like, my teammates didn't have their knees and legs covered. We had to have our legs and stuff covered. Man, they was fining us left and right, man. So towards the middle of the season, later in the season, we kind of started doing our own thing. But I was able to wear these in practice. I really enjoy this particular alpha right here, because this is everything to me. My mom was everything to me. So now we're gonna get into some of the cleats. So my favorite cleat of all time is Vapors, bro. Like, it's no better cleat than Vapors. I have these Vapors right here, and these were used when I was in Germany. I played for the Osnabrück Tigers. I played quarterback for them as well. And these were a cleat that I bought like right when I got over there. Look at the detail on that. Like, I'm pretty sure most athletes have seen this cleat before. But yeah, it's a dope cleat. These right here is another pair of Vapors. But we went inside of like Marshalls or Ross, like right up the street from our facility, and we found these guys. These were super dope. I had never seen them before. They were definitely different, $20. And that's the good thing about Marshalls and Ross, because like they be having some nice ass cleats and stuff for the low. Feel me? The low. The last vapor of this kind right here. It's simple, man. I got these just simply because they black and white. You can never go wrong with a black and white cleat, man. These are dope right here, man. Very simple. One thing I will say about these vapors, man, is that they are very narrow. Look how narrow this shoe is. Like, that shoe is like super narrow. So like, when I get these kind of cleats, I go a size up just cause I want to be comfortable, you feel me? Now these right here, I'm about to show y'all not ready for this. My Carbon 2.0s, man. Favorite vapor of all time. These are my favorite vapors, man. These are the most comfortable vapors, man. These were the Seattle Seahawks vapors. For everybody that doesn't know, once again, I played quarterback overseas. That's my first year playing quarterback overseas for the Bremerhaven Seahawks. And these were my favorite cleat over in Germany. But now we're gonna get to the bread and butter, man, to the gloves. Everybody know I got 50 million pair of gloves, and this is what a lot of my subscribers been waiting on. Everybody always asking me how many pair of gloves I got. Like every team I go to, I'm always donating gloves to my teammates because they be needing and wanting them for the games and stuff. So this right here is about to get real detail oriented right here, man. This right here is a vapor. I lost the other glove when I was in Texas playing arena football, but this is what they look like. The reason I really like these because they real stretchy. Like a lot of the vapors and stuff, like they real stiff and it's hard to get your hand in, but these right here are real stretchy. Now, this one is because when I play quarterback, I have to wear a glove because my hands are not that big. I have a hard time getting my whole entire hand around the ball. So if I grip the ball or whatever, it gives me a lot more grip with these gloves on. This grip is A1. Sit tight, cause we got a little minute now. We on the gloves, we got a little minute. This next glove is gonna be a vapor, but this one is gonna be blue. So I got these, cause I did play receiver there too. But like I said, I use a glove. I've always used a glove to throw the ball as well, so. Then we got these right here. We had the flat joints. These are considered kind of like OGs, but not OGs. But if you see those, a lot of people still have these. If you have a favorite glove or you have a favorite like setup or anything, comment down below and let me know, man. Cause I'm curious to see what my subscribers like what they like to rock, man. I mean, you want to do just enough to kind of like catch that eye. Somebody like, oh yeah, bro. Bro, dripping. Yeah, so I got these two. These, I will honestly say, like, I used these, I think, when I was in Germany. Playing quarterback. And the only thing about these, man, is that they're not stretchy. So, like me getting my hand, I felt like my hand was, like, super stiff trying to, like, grip the ball and stuff. But they are definitely a good receiver glove. They still got grip. And then on these, I always have to go up a size larger. I wear a size large gloves, but these are a size extra large because they're so like narrow and stiff. These right here, these probably one of the newer pair of gloves that I have. I've been seeing a lot of people with them. Great glove. I love the color scheme. Everybody know when I played for quarterback for the Omaha Beef, our colors was black and orange. So I thought this was a dope combination. And I actually warmed up in these gloves. But I never use them. Never use. If you like these gloves right here, man, maybe I'll throw into one of my subscribers, you feel me, if y'all want a nice little pair of gloves. I got a special pair over here. This pair right here, still to this day, one of my favorite pair of gloves. These are my Phenom Elite gloves. The first pair of Phenom Elite gloves I was ever sent out to me. Um, And they still got, y'all hear that, like, still got good grip. Like, I still use these to this day. Feel me? So I love this, like, scheme. It's like the OG Nike scheme. Like, it's real drippy. So I fuck with that hard just because it's just the OG kind of feel. Yeah, man, shout out to Phenom Elite for that. This is my second pair of Phenom Elite gloves. Tell y'all about when my mom passed away, so the colon cancer situation. So this was the pair that I was gonna wear with my my outfits. I'm a big fan of solid gloves. So like solid color gloves, bro, it'll get me every time. So I was gonna go with this scheme here with these gloves. I know that's a little bit darker, but you get the picture. These are my Phenom Elite. Is that upside down? Yeah. We got another pair of the Vapors. Boy, Vapor, man, they come a long way, bro. They come out with something fire every year, bro. We got these right here. These are similar to one of the ones I showed y'all before. They're a little bit different, but this is the scheme. I can't, it's harder for me to like grip the ball, but catching wise, yeah, A1. So I remember we had an away game with the Salina Liberty in the Arena League, and I wore these. They are military appreciation. I'll never give these up either, just because it's just a dope glove. I just love, and I haven't really found any more since I got that one. Hey, but these right here, everybody know these one of my favorite gloves. I haven't had these since college. Still sticky, super sticky. Feel me? Grip been kind of worn off of there, as you see at the top where the fingers are. But they still the most nastiest, grippiest glove I have. These are my favorites, bro. Like, and they kind of coming off, but I don't care. Nobody straps these up anyway. You lining up, man, like, woo, it's over with.
Stop it. Get some help.
Yeah, yeah, hey, these my favorite gloves. I done had these since college, so. I'm just gonna let y'all know straight up. My boy Sean gave me these. We traded gloves last year. Shout out to Sean, man. That's been my homie, one of my best friends for a minute now. We play arena football together, and he gave me these. I hope he don't want these back, because he ain't getting them. These are one of my favorite too, and I think it's more so because it's this kind of vapor. These are like the most grippiest ones. Like, they never lose grip, so they got the Ravens theme on there. Super dope. These right here, my black pair are, these black pair are my favorites. So this right here, I love this part right here. Like, it's super dope. Like, if you wear all black, like your team got all black, black jerseys, black pants, you gotta put the black socks. If you wear a spat, you gotta spat black. You don't wanna do too much. You get an all black uniform, man, and you wear it with this, man, it's over with. It's super icy. This right here, once again, all black cutters. I don't know why everybody say that cutters. Well, a lot of people say that cutters are better than Nike, but ain't nobody shit on Nike, bro. But they good to play receiver in. They just not grippable glove. So then, you know, as a quarterback and as a receiver too, you gotta have a little drip. You feel me? I got my my arm sleeve. You feel me? I don't really ever try to wear two sleeves because it look a little weird, but. Got the arm sleeve right here. Mouthpiece wise, so lately I've been wearing a grill in my mouth, like, just because it looked dope. Nah, it looks super dope. This is my go-to, like, the battle mouthpiece. As an athlete, you gotta have battle mouthpiece. I like my pads small. Everybody know, and I'm not even a small guy. I'm 6'2". A little over 200 pounds, but I like smaller pads because it give me a lot more room to throw in. It give me a lot more room to like run around and my range of motion and all that stuff. But these are my pads. I have the Zenith Fly pads with the back plate. Most favorite pads that I've ever had. I've had the Shut, like, Power something. I don't remember, bro, but They got the little back piece right here, and they got the sternum piece in the front. But you gotta have the back flap. And let me explain something else to y'all. Y'all boys who wear them back flaps that's way down here, we gotta stop that. With the shoestrings, we gotta stop that. Man, we all about having it at a decent length. That way, if like you can't, if you do put your jersey over it, it still look hard. You feel me? And if you do have it out, it's still gonna look decent. But you don't wanna have, you gotta make sure you get the original pieces to it, man. Cause you're wearing shoestrings and stuff, you're gonna be looking bummy. So we're gonna get straight to the helmet. So everybody know me, I've always been a Riddell Speed Flex guy. But since they came out with these F7s, man, I have been in love, like, in love. Now this is my primary helmet. I did have the Tariq Hill face mask on here, but due to the team that I've been playing with, they said we have to have red face masks. So I decided to try this one. I think Deion Kane had this helmet for the Steelers. I put this one on here. I got the shock visor, the shock 2.0 visor on here, and that's a clear mirror. I did change out the bumper on the top here. I had the original shut bumper that's kind of like octagon-y looking. I put regular clips on here just so that I could fit my visor on here. I'll take a look at this right here. See how y'all can see clear through that? But when you in that arena, bruh, it look way different. This right here is my favorite helmet right now, man. This is definitely my favorite helmet right here. We got the Speed Flex with the Shock 0G, man. Shout out to Shock. I'ma always shout them boys out. You feel me? But shout out to Shock. So I got the quarterback face mask on here. I had a quarterback face mask on my F7 too as well. Just because you can play wide receiver and quarterback with this face mask. And I basically had the F7 version of this on my F7. So it's better for me to have this open so I can have like full vision or whatever. And it makes a difference to me. I don't know about some people, but I'm gonna let y'all take a full look at this helmet. You turn this around, man. It's got all the details, all the NFL stickers, everything on there, you feel me? So this is definitely a special helmet, and I'll probably never paint this helmet. So if I do decide to go back to a Speed Flex, I'll probably have one sent out to me. That just kind of sums up a little bit of my football wardrobe, man. Just be looking out for a lot more content, man. Shout out always to my boys Jarvis and Nabari, also my boy at Shock James. And make sure you like, comment, and subscribe, and share to all your friends, athletes, non-athletes, mama, daddy, son, shana, hey, oh nah, but anyways, so make sure y'all subscribe, and make sure y'all stay tuned, because I am doing a giveaway at 200 subscribers, man. I am giving 2 subscribers, not 1, but 2 subscribers, a Shock 0G visor. That's this visor right here. This visor right here, I will be giving y'all a Shock 0G visor. And just make sure y'all stay tuned. Make sure y'all put those notifications on and make sure y'all watch my video, man, because I got a lot of good content coming out, man. We're gonna be posting something every week, man. Make sure y'all subscribe. I'm gonna put the link below for my boy Jarvis and Nabari's channel. And I'm gonna also put a link in there for y'all to order some of y'all some Shock apparel. I'll also put my team Shock code in there for you guys so you can get a little bit of percentage off on some Shock apparel or equipment. So make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And thank you for watching, man. What's good, y'all? If y'all like the content y'all seen today, make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Turn on all your notifications and make sure y'all stay tuned up and up to date with everything I have going on. And don't forget that I'm also doing a giveaway to 2 lucky subscribers. Once I get to 200 subscribers, I will give away 2 prizes. I'm giving away 2 prizes, not 1, but 2 prizes. It's going to be 2 Shock 0G visors, man, and you don't want to miss out on that.